good ones. I can sort of show. Since they're down. Yeah, that's not too bad. Awesome tree this is. We're over here at Norman Hall and checking out this big giant live oak. And these are some of my favorite trees of all. Live oaks are iconic in the South. They're really great trees. In Florida, we see them all over the place. They get huge and they're really a long-lived species. They can live up to 500 plus years old. Man, it's giant, right? And so you can really see how big this tree is, how much shade it produces with its sprawling canopy, and it's a fantastic tree. Look at this bark, it's really thick. It can get quite thick. Look, it's almost, you know, the length of my finger there. And so it can get quite thick. It's dark brown color, very blocky, and that's a very distinct feature. You can identify these trees from a distance just by the bark alone. Within the branches, you'll find Spanish moss hanging down. And Spanish moss is actually an interesting species in and of itself. It's not a true moss. It's actually a close relative, believe it or not, of pineapple. And so they're a flowering plant as well. The tree in and of itself is its own ecosystem. Look at this beautiful tree. It's got great architecture. All kinds of branches going everywhere. Reminds me of the trees when I was a kid. This is Southern Magnolia. The genus is Magnolia, and the species is Grandiflora. And it's known as Grandiflora because it has these beautiful white flowers. It has these wonderful leaves. And if you see them, you know, they're big leaves. They're shiny, dark green. And if you touch them, they're really thick and leathery feeling. And that's because they're an evergreen species. So they don't drop their leaves, they hold on to them. Here's a bud that fell off the tree that is about to fly, a flower that's about to open. It hasn't opened yet. And you can sort of see when we tear into it. And there's the reproductive portions of the tree. So that's pretty cool. There's a nice shot of the flower right here. You can really see why they're so attractive. Beautiful creamy white flowers. Got a nice smell to it. Think about how many pollinators use these, and that's certainly a concern right now, the loss of our pollinators. So these are really important trees from that perspective as well. This is Pinus palustris, or longleaf pine. And they're called longleaf pine because the needles on them are particularly long. Look at some of these. They're very, very long needles right here. Look at that. It's over a foot long. They come in little bundles of three. We have many different pine species in Florida, but this is one that was once dominant across the Southeast. Used to cover around 90 million acres. And then over time, as a result of logging and lack of fire and invasive species like wild hogs, we really lost the longleaf pine across its native range. They produce really big cones. This one, it was a cone, and now squirrels have found it, and so it's the remnants of a cone, but they produce these really large cones. These are the male cones, or the pollen producing parts of the plant. And so when you got those yellow pollen on your car at certain times of the year, this is the culprit, all right? Thanks for coming along on this journey with me. I hope you learned a little bit of something about trees along the way, and I encourage you to keep on learning. Happy Earth Day.